room, Bucky. Compliments of the house.
Why?
I see all the big shots when they get off and on trains. If they got the picture on the front page, paper's on me. Here. Take a look. Nice picture, huh?
Add 5 years to it, it would look just like me.
Gee, it must feel great. Out of the junk and a big shot again. You lead some life, huh, Rocky?
Yeah. I'm a real dinger.
Rocky. How you been?
You might say all right, Gus, but I wouldn't.
Treated you rough today.
Oh, I got a couple of bruises. Up there.
Well, you're out now.
Yeah, and what's 5 years? You could do that just sitting around and waiting.
Aren't you going to say hello to your buddy, DeLong?
It's been a long time, Rocky. I guess I changed.
Glad to see you. I owe you plenty.
All right, now I'll settle for a drink.
I've forgotten the right words. I wouldn't even know how to order.
Let me do it. I'll buy.
Homecoming present?
That, plus the fact I'd like to talk to you.
The man wants to buy. Never argue with a policeman.
A detective.
Thanks. What do you say, Rocky?
Well, I had different plans for my first one, but my friend here looks thirsty.
I'm always thirsty.
No hard feelings, Rocky.
Don't bet any large amounts on that, Gus.
Could have been worse. A month ago, you were up for life. Then your friend here turns up with your alibi.
I gave you that same alibi 5 years ago.
You'll have to admit it was a little thin. You said you were out drinking with some Marines when the holdup took place. Only the Marines never show up.
We landed only 5 years late. Sorry to keep you waiting, pal.
No, that's all right. I just would have wasted my time having fun anyway.
We all got shipped out after that night. I guess you don't remember any of the other boys.
I couldn't remember any of your names.
And they all got it one way or another. I misplaced a leg somewhere, so I never heard about the mess you were in until I got back about a month ago.
How did Danny Morgan feel about your getting out?
Well, how should he feel? It's no comfort station they run up there.
Too bad he couldn't dig up a Marine to alibi him.
Look, Gus, if this is just a social get-together, why not skip it?
I want to talk to you about the money from the holdup.
You should read my pardon. It says I didn't have anything to do with the holdup.
$100,000, and not a penny of it has ever shown up.
Maybe it got inflated right out of existence.
I figure you might know where that money is.
Figure anything you want. I'm a citizen again.
I'm going to keep a tail on you, Rocky. 24 hours a day.
It shouldn't be too tough a job. I'm not going anywhere.
When you do, we'll be right with you.
Where do you figure I might go that would interest you, Gus?
You'll make a play for that money. It'll be easier than going to work. If I get you again, Rocky, the Army, Navy, and Marines won't be able to help you.
You buy nice drinks, mister. But you talk so much.
Goodbye, Mr. DeLong. I'll be seeing you, Rocky.
I'll count the hours.
Hey, Mac. Two more over here. Let's move. Well, pal, you're now a free man again. Any questions?
Just one.
Shoot.
Who are you?
I figured you might be curious about that.
You weren't one of the guys I was out with that night.
I could have been. I was a Marine. I was here in town that night.
But you weren't one of them.
No. It's all very simple, pal. I heard about your case, checked up on it in the newspaper files, found out I fitted your alibi perfectly. Here you are.
Why'd you do it?
Occasionally, I always drink too much.
You went to a lot of trouble.
Wasn't too tough. I wore all my decorations. I've got plenty.
Eventually, you'll get around to telling me why.
Not eventually. Right now. You were up for life. It was the 100,000 bucks kicking around, so I figured you might be grateful if I got you out.
You You not only picked the wrong horse, you didn't even get the right track.
Life could be beautiful with money.
Maybe you didn't hear me. I didn't pull that stick-up.
You'd be an awful big disappointment to me if you didn't.
So I'm a big disappointment?
You didn't do it.
No. But I know who did.
Now I feel better. You know, I think I'm just like that policeman. I think I'll stick around for a while and see what you're up to.
Then come on. I want to introduce you to a pretty girl. Nice car. I understand these things cost money now.
I traded my left leg for it. Who's this girl we're gonna meet?
Wife of a friend of mine.
Sounds like a dirty trick, but I'm for it.
She's Danny's wife, the guy I went to jail with.
Is she really pretty?
She's out of bounds. I said she was Danny's wife.
Glad I never met the guy.
Danny's one of my favorite people.
Okay, Rocky, I never was one to argue with a criminal type. She has to be the wife of a friend.
Run amok, Junior. That's the wrong girl.
Hello, fellas.
A happy Mother's Day to you, too.
I'm Darlene Levine.
I'll bet you are that, dear. Tell me, where can I find the manager?
Williams? Oh, he's probably over there in the office.
Thanks.
You fellas gonna live here?
Maybe, if you're a good girl and go to church on Sundays.
Aren't you the fresh one?
Mm-hmm.
Sail across the sea, she ran away from me to meet another man. It was a dirty trick. She got me off.
Hey, Godfrey, where can I find the manager?
You're talking to
him. I want to rent a trailer for two.
When and for how long?
Now and I don't know.
$10 a week.
It'll break our backs, but I think we can swing it.
All right.
Follow me.
Hey, Rocky. I hope you were kidding about us staying here.
Only a couple of days. Darlene will keep you company.
I'd rather take her out of all this than move in with her.
This is it.
Oh, swell. House beautiful. What are we, the poor relations? What about some of those places back there?
This is all I got left.
The one that didn't fall down before we got here.
Well, the place looks lived in.
Yeah, but by what?
Take it or leave it, $10 a week.
Well, you're a smooth salesman, Mr. Williams. You talked us into it. Be careful how you spend that. It was a present from the taxpayers.
Say. Ain't you Rocky Malloy?
Well, I guess you could say that.
Look, Mr. Malloy, I don't want any trouble in this camp.
Then don't start any.
You see, I got a nice little setup with lots of transits.
We like it. It's quaint.
There's no hot water. Suppose you wanted a shave.
We'll ring for you.
I think I'll go take care of Darlene. Another man might walk by.
Just a week, Mr. Malloy, huh?
I don't know. You got a Nancy Morgan living here?
Yeah, she lives in Trailer 8.
She in now?
She works across town someplace.
What time does she usually get home?
In about an hour. No kidding, Mr. Malloy. I
got a bag in the car. Go get it, will you?
Let's get out of this hot sun into a nice, cool bar.
In a few minutes, honey.
So it's honey already?
I call everybody honey.
Darlene, what do you do?
Well, I'm sort of a part-time model.
Oh.
I don't get it, Rocky. Why do you want to fool around with that Nancy Morgan when I've got a lot of friends more cute and more fun?
I may call on you for help later.
I'd like to see me with $100,000 hidden away someplace and just getting out of 5 years in the clink. Wow. You know, alongside one of my friends, that Nancy Morgan's a deep freeze unit.
What about that saloon we were gonna look up?
In a few minutes, honey. Of course, you being her husband's friend helped a lot. I guess it'd be all right if you took her out, wouldn't you say?
I'd say you talk too much.
Hey, you gonna sit there and let him talk to me like that?
Nope. Let's go to some nice, quiet place where we can't hear him.
He's got some nerve.
Look, you run along and wait for me in the car, huh?
I'd still be willing to forgive him for getting call up a girl for him.
Run along, darling, before I fracture your spine.
Some funny guy, aren't you?
Gonna go after that money pretty soon, eh, Rocky?
Pretty soon, yep.
Don't wait up for me.
I don't like it at all, Mr. Malloy.
Well, I'm sorry to hear that. I wish I knew what you were talking about.
There's been a man in my office asking questions about you.
Irish guy, looks like a saint, acts like a thug.
That's right. I think he's a cop.
I know he is.
I've been thinking about things. That Mrs. Morgan, she's the wife of the guy who pulled the stick up with you, isn't she?
No, she isn't, because we didn't pull any stick up.
Well, what I meant...
What's bothering you?
I don't like the cops hanging around.
Well, forget about the cops. They're not interested in any two-bit setup you got here.
Well, I don't want any trouble.
Look, is my rent paid?
Yeah.
Don't stop bothering me.
I still don't want any trouble.
Neither do I, from you or anybody else.
Rocky!
Hello, Nancy.
Better grab me quick before my knees give way.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to surprise you this way.
Well, that's all right. I knew you'd be here. Let me look at you.
No change, same height, same weight.
Oh, you look fine. When did you get in?
A few hours ago.
I moved Mr. Malloy in, Mrs. Morgan.
I'm in Inner Sanctum, number 12.
I thought we all ought to get together and have a little talk.
Goodbye,
huh?
Mr. Williams.
Hungry?
Wasn't I always?
You were lucky to get a place here. Mr. Williams likes couples.
Well, he got one. DeLong's with me.
Oh, the Marine.
That's right.
Invite him to dinner. We'll put more water in the soup.
He's out bar hopping with a gal named, believe it if you can, Darlene Levon.
When the Marines land, Darlene's always there waiting for them.
Hey, this is nice.
What a break, Rocky. He's showing up after all this time.
It's more than a break. It's more like a miracle.
How is Danny?
Just fine. Told me to have a drink with you for him.
Is he really all right?
Nothing wrong with him that getting out wouldn't fix.
Only 6 more months.
With luck.
Did he mind your getting out very much since he had to stay?
I couldn't do him any good up there. Maybe I can down here.
Oh? How?
Well, DeLong proved they were wrong about me. I'm going to prove the same thing about Danny.
You're going to try to open up the whole thing again?
I'm going to turn it inside out.
But that just sounds like more trouble.
What more can happen to us? We've had 5 years yanked out of our lives. That's a long time when you break it up into hours.
Why don't you fix us that drink, Rocky? It's in the cupboard.
All right. You stop worrying. Remember the day I introduced you to Danny? I was so proud of my girl, I wanted to show her off.
That was a long time ago.
20 centuries. You both deserve a better break than this hanging over your heads the rest of your lives.
Rocky, you never told me how you felt after we had that quarrel and Danny and I got married.
You know how I felt. I crawled away and died for a few weeks.
Only for a few weeks. It lasted longer than that with me.
But you wouldn't change it now.
Of course not. Sometimes, I wonder...
Don't. Not even sometimes.
Rocky, why can't we just forget everything that's happened?
Forget?
I mean about the prison and you and Danny and the holdup. Even if you are innocent...
Even if I'm innocent?
I didn't mean it that way.
Of course you did.
No, I didn't. It wouldn't make any difference to me if you and Danny were involved.
But we weren't.
I know you weren't. Oh, Rocky, why do you twist everything I say?
Oh, big homecoming. I'm showing you a bad time. Sorry. Looks like Lassie's home. Come along, I'll introduce you.
pull up some dust and sit down. You, of course, would be Nancy.
Of course.
You're out of bounds.
Am I?
According to my underworld friend.
Where's Darlene?
I'm very disappointed in Darlene. She turned out to be a part-time model and a full-time pickpocket. We may very well have visitors before long.
What happened?
We had a great many drinks in this place she knew about, and when she thought I was tight enough, she went for my bankroll.
Country boy said a girl.
I slapped her wrist. The bartender didn't like that.
What about the bartender?
I let him have it over the head with a peanut machine. He's resting now in the emergency hospital.
Oh, swell. You better run along. He's right about the visitors.
But what about you if the police come?
We're old friends. We can always find things to talk about.
Oh, Rocky.
See you tomorrow.
All right.
Good night.
Good night.
Have you read that book, What to Do Until the Police Come?
I know all the answers. The bartender gave me a drink that tasted funny. And I don't remember anything after that.
Give me the keys to your car.
You burglars always work at night, don't you?
And about $10.
Sure, sure. We're partners. You want me to go along?
No, thanks.
Oh, if you run into Darlene, tell her all is forgiven.
DeLong, you go for that bottle an awful lot. You never get to the point where you say things you shouldn't, do you?
What milk is to a baby, that is to me. Go commit your crimes with an easy mind.
I'll see you later.
I sincerely hope so.
Where are you going, Rocky?
I've got to go see someone. How long have they been here?
They just got here. Isn't that a little foolish, carrying a gun just the day after you got out?
You better go to bed, Nancy.
Be careful.
I will. Now, you wouldn't be looking for a fellow named DeLong, would you?
Yeah, do you know him?
Friend of mine, ex-Marine. Wants to file a complaint with you boys.
He wants to file a complaint?
That's right. A bartender in some gin mill down the road got him tight, tried to roll him. Works with a dame named Darlene from here, I think.
Well, now, that's not the way we heard it. The bartender said that DeLong got fresh.
Well, of course he'd say that. Why would he tell the truth?
Darlene's a good kid. She wouldn't tell a lie.
Look, DeLong is carrying quite a role. Anybody who'd try to rob a one-legged Marine hero is three kinds of a crumb, wouldn't you think?
Yeah, but how do we know?
Well, go talk to him. I think the bartender's getting off easy. He ought to pick up his license for running a clip joint.
Where is this DeLong?
Inside.
Come on, I'll show you.
$0.35, please, sir.
There's a man following me. He'll want to know where I am. It'll save him a lot of trouble. Tell him Rocky Malloy's in there.
After Los Amigos?
That's right. Keep the change.
I'll tell him, Mr. Rocky.
Lately?
Don't tell me you can't read yet.
Just trying to be delicate.
Buy yourself a drink.
With $10, I could buy the joint. Not many tips like this around here.
I want to surprise Castro. Thought maybe you'd forget how to use that telephone.
Sure, Rocky, sure.
I might buy another round on the way down.
Fine, fine. Oh, Rocky, thanks for the dough. But you shouldn't have bothered. Castro's expecting you anyway.
That's all right, Russell. I got that $10 from a typhoid carrier.
Nice to see you, Rocky.
Yeah, I imagine you've been looking forward to this.
It's always nice to see an old friend.
Get up from your desk. Sit over there. We can talk better. I've been reading so many detective stories lately, I guess I'm just naturally suspicious.
I don't blame you. Imagine you're kind of sore, huh, Rocky?
Well, I was planning on taking you to dinner.
That's quite a break you're getting, huh?
Not for you. When I went up Castro, I was making $20,000 a year. 5 years, it's $100,000. I'm willing to split the difference with you, settle for half.
Dollar's only worth 50 cents these days.
I'll stand a loss.
Why should I, Rocky?
Because that was the deal you made when you dreamed up the job. I drive the car, I get 50,000.
Yeah, but you didn't come in on it.
Everybody pretended like I did. The cops, the judge, and a lot of guards up at prison.
You told that story to the jury about me propositioning you. Couldn't make it stick then, how can you now?
I don't have to make it stick with you. We know different. Besides, I'm not out to prove anything. I'm just here to collect some money.
I only got half. Do you want all of my share?
That's cheaper than dying.
Would you kill me, Rocky?
Wouldn't you?
I'll tell you what. Why don't I set you up in a new book, hmm?
I just want $10,000 a year for 5 of the best years of my life.
Can I reach in my pocket?
Go ahead.
That's $500.
It's 1%.
Put it on a horse called Dragonfly. But place it with another book, huh?
Suppose it loses?
It won't. Should pay about 8 to 1. That's $4,000.
What about the other 46?
You know, things have changed around here in the last 5 years, Rocky. I'm 60% legitimate now.
I see.
I'm what you might call a pretty big man.
Good, then you won't miss the money so much.
You know, big men don't scare easy.
And big men must get popped off pretty regularly. Where do I place the bet?
Call me in the morning.
Big, legitimate man like you. Still playing with loaded guns. Nice to have me back, huh, Castro?
Hey, mister. You owe me 2 bits for the game.
Want to shine, Gus?
You didn't want to recognize me in there, huh?
I got a bad reputation. I got to be careful who I'm seen with.
You went to a lot of trouble to make sure I'd know where you were.
Why?
I want to make your work easy for you.
I don't want you to make it too easy. You have some business with Castro?
Well, we're thinking about opening up an ice cream parlor together.
Look, I'm tailing you myself, and I want to get some sleep. What are your plans for the rest of the night?
Home and mother.
Don't cross me up, Rocky.
You wouldn't believe it, Gus, but I want you with me wherever I go.
I'll try and be there.
Good. Pay for my shine, too, will you? I'm fresh out of hot money.
Thank you. It's me.
What are you doing up?
I thought I heard something.
What?
Something like a shot.
Smell it.
Huh?
Smell the barrel. If it's been fired, you can smell it.
Nothing.
Remember that if you decide to call the cops and tell them I've been shooting at the place. Now turn in.
Such people you run around with. Can't sleep, huh?
No.
I could never sleep after I'd been shot at either. One thing's sure. You certainly stirred up plenty of action. You must be getting close to the money.
I just took a walk. Saw a few people.
Must have liked you. They followed you home.
Go to sleep.
I had an interesting evening after I got rid of the cops.
Good for you.
I had a drink with Nancy. She stuck on you. You're stuck on her. She's out of bounds, remember? You got a big problem, boy. Out of bounds. Married your best friend. Yeah, you got a problem.
Shut up and go to sleep.
Is the door locked?
You can relax. The boogeyman's gone.
Good night.
Good night.
Shower?
I couldn't even turn it on.
You're drinking that stuff so early.
Listen, doll girl, when you drink as much as I do, you gotta start early.
Well, you two made up?
Darlene's gonna give up pickpocketing and start studying forgery.
Aren't you ashamed of yourself, Darlene?
I was only gonna keep his money for him till he sobered up.
That's like tying it up permanently. Can I use your car today?
It's just a stock model, no armor on it.
How about some coffee, Rocky?
Fine, I'll be right in.
Your girlfriend know anything about the shooting last night?
Why should she?
Just asking.
Gonna have a little party tonight. Keep yourselves available.
That's me, available.
There's nothing I like better than a party.
Would you like some coffee cake?
No, thanks. There was a time when we used to think about having breakfast together every morning.
Things go haywire, don't they?
They do if you let things happen instead of make them happen. I thought you'd be at work.
Not for a half hour yet. Rocky, tell me what you're doing.
I don't know myself yet. Just probing a few sore spots.
And getting shot at.
No. Williams gets up early. I don't think they were trying very hard to hit me. Just to scare me off.
From what? Where did you go last night?
I called on someone who may be able to clear Danny and me, if I play it right.
Did you talk to Danny about what you're going to do?
As much as I could. I only had about 5 minutes with him before I left.
And what did he say?
He's like you. Leave well enough alone.
Then why don't you?
Well, Danny only got 1 to 10. I got life. I guess I'm just that much madder than he is.
Where are you going today?
Well, there was a witness at the trial named Fletcher. I thought maybe I might call on him.
I'll go with you.
Mm-mm.
Why not?
Just in case that guy last night wasn't trying to miss, I'd like to keep you out of it.
You know, this concerns me a little bit too, Rocky.
You're awfully pretty alive. I'd like to keep you that way. Now, drink up. I'll go change clothes and drive you to work.
All right, I'll be ready in a few minutes.
Next time, make my coffee a little stronger, huh?
Oh, yes. I remember.
What are you smiling about?
It used to annoy you when I moved the mirror.
Still does. Funny, I forgot to ask you. What are you doing for a living now?
I'm a secretary.
When did this happen?
When Danny went to jail, I had to find a job.
I suppose it wasn't too easy to find one after the trial and all.
People forget, if you let them. Turn left at the next corner.
I'll pay you back for breakfast at dinner tonight.
What are you using for money these days?
Well, I've got a horse and a third at Burlington that's collateral for a bank loan.
Sometimes they break a leg.
They got a picture of this one running first before the race even starts.
Take care of yourself.
Fletcher apartment?
I don't need any brushes, but come on in.
Mrs. Fletcher?
Yes?
I'd like to see your husband.
Well, that's not very flattering. Would you like some coffee?
Oh, second cup never hurt anybody.
Cream and sugar?
Black, please.
My name is Alice. Mind if I call you Rocky?
Why should you?
Because that's your name. What do you want with my husband? Get him to admit he was wrong about identifying you?
Well, a guy could make a mistake. He's had 5 years to think it over.
I guess you don't know about Arthur.
What about Arthur?
Arthur's dead. Fletcher Arthur, 43. Service is Monday, 2 p.m., Little Church of the Roses, Memorial Chapel. Cremation follows. Heart attack 2 years ago. He was 16 years older than me.
You seem all cut up about it.
He'd have died of shock anyway if he'd known you were getting out. What do you want with Arthur? You're in the clear now.
I've still got a good friend doing time on his identification. Tell me, did your husband ever say anything about maybe being mistaken?
Arthur wasn't much of a talker.
Oh, come on. What difference can it make to you now?
None. Particularly since the money's all gone.
Money?
Arthur came into a small inheritance just about the time of your trial.
How small?
$5,000.
Must have been nice for you.
He bought me some new clothes.
Who left him the money?
I never asked him.
Would you tell the police about it?
And get picked up as an accessory?
I can have them check his bank account for that period.
The money was left to us in cash. We kept it here and we spent it in cash. I'll deny all this, Rocky. So don't bother trying to involve me.
Why did you tell me?
You wanted to know. Besides, you look like such a nice man.
If I promise not to involve you, will you tell the nice man who gave Arthur the money?
Drink your coffee.
He's an awfully swell guy still sweating out a prison rap.
Look, I'm sorry about the swell guy, but I never was involved in this, and I don't intend to start now.
Well, thanks anyway.
You're not leaving. Just when I thought things were beginning to get interesting.
In what way?
Well, we don't have to spend the rest of our lives talking about dead husbands and holdups.
What else could we talk about?
Me. Or maybe you don't find that very interesting.
Can I use your telephone?
Help yourself.
This is Rocky Malloy. Give me Castro, will you? Hello, Castro. You told me to call. Where do I place that bet? Crosley Hotel, cigar stand? I'll be seeing you. Now, where were we?
You were on your way out.
Well, I thought we were going to sit around and talk about you.
Well, we're not. Get out of here.
Oh. So my call to Castro didn't set too well, huh?
I said beat it.
Someday, Alice, you and I are going to have a nice long talk. And you'll really do some talking.
Go on, get out of here.
You said that. Those cigarettes, please. I want to see the man. Not a horse.
What makes you think this is
that
kind of...
I don't think. Castro sent me.
You're a friend of Castro's?
We've met. Maybe you've heard of me. First name's Rocky.
I've seen your face.
In all the papers, society section.
The pictures don't do you justice, Rocky. What horse?
Put this on Dragonfly and the third at Burlington. Right there. $500.
That's a lot of money to throw away on a very long shot.
In case I win, what happens? Do I see you again?
No. The delicatessen downstairs. Ask for Harry. But you can still see me again.
Especially if I win.
It won't matter. I work here every day, and I live upstairs in room 201.
Thanks. I'll see what my nurse says.
They're off, bound, running. At the start, it's Rule 2, breaking on top. Flying Cap is second, Papoose is third. Morningside is fourth, Fast Fury is fifth. Dragonfly and Red Satin. Down the back stretch, it's Rule 2, leading by a length and a half. Morningside is second by a half a length. Papoose on the outside is third by three quarters. Flying Cap is fourth by one length. Red Satin is next by a neck. And Dragonfly is closing ground on the rail. Around the turn, it's Rule 2, leading by a half a length. Papoose challenging on the outside is second by three quarters. Morningside is third by one length. Flying Cap and Dragonfly. Dragonfly trying to get through on the rail and can't find racing room. He's going to the outside. They're in the stretch, and it's Rule 2 leading by a head. Papoose is second by a neck. Morningside is third by three quarters. And now Dragonfly is going to a drive on the outside. Here comes Dragonfly. They're coming down to the wire, and it's Papoose and Dragonfly. It's Papoose by a head and Dragonfly, and it's going to be closer. Now it's Dragonfly and Papoose, and it's Dragonfly, the winner, by a nose. Papoose is second by three quarters of a length. Rule Two is third by one length, and Morningside finished fourth.
$4,000, huh? Well, I'll credit it to your account. You, Harry?
No. Wait a minute, I'll get him.
Hey, Harry.
Five to one, I know why you're here.
Yep. Same horse. Now, that's the way it goes. That horse has really knocked me over today. You wouldn't believe it if I told you this was the biggest loss of my whole career. Really.
Great for you guys. So what if a bookie gets hit hard?
It's a big joke. Big joke. Never occurs to you that I got a wife and kids like other people. Well, there goes the 2 weeks at camp I promised the kids this summer. $4,000. What are you going to do with all that loot?
Get an operation so I can play my violin again.
Oh, swell. Big joke.
Santa Claus, soldier.
I was a Marine, not a soldier. For a while there, I began to think you'd gone south with my car.
Busy day.
Santa bring something for me?
That he did. Here. Read this. Might improve your mind.
Does drinking affect your social life?
Here's an orchid for Darlene. And I got a little something for you here that might keep her interested in you tonight.
Where are we going?
Got a big celebration. There.
Looks like about $1,000.
It should.
He must have found the guy who did it.
I had a horse working for me today.
The horse give you the money to put down on himself?
You got a right to know what I'm up to if you want to.
I don't. Nancy's been after me all day to talk you out of doing whatever you're doing.
Oh?
Okay, I've talked.
Well, thanks.
You know, I don't think Nancy's as worried about you personally as she pretends to be.
What do you mean?
I mean, I think she's more worried about what you might stir up.
You're a pint ahead of schedule.
Only the blind can really see.
Well, you're only half blind.
I'll fix that.
You know, I had another friend once who had trouble with that stuff. He found a way to get off of it.
How?
He quit.
Thank you, Billy Sunday.
Comb your hair. We'll leave as soon as the girls are ready.
Why they ordered all this food, they're still dancing.
Maybe they like cold steaks. Or maybe they're just working up an appetite.
I'd say they were stuck on each other.
What difference does it make? Hey, waiter. You better put these steaks back in the oven. Oh, and cancel that strawberry shortcake and bring me a double bourbon. I got a bad tooth.
Mighty handsome present, this dress.
Mighty handsome girl inside it. This is like old times, Nancy.
Except I could never get you to dance.
Funny, I like it now. I must have mellowed.
Remember the last time we danced together?
At the beach one summer.
Mm-hmm. The summer I asked you to marry me. 3 times.
3 times? No wonder I lost out to the other guy.
That horse must have paid good odds.
8 to 1.
Did DeLong tell you I'd talk to him?
Yes, but let's relax and have fun tonight.
I'm really worried, Rocky.
Oh, Nancy. You can't have any fun that way.
Well, the marathon dancers are back.
Gee, that's a pretty dress. So beside you, I look terrible.
Good old Darlene. Honest as the day is long.
Hello, Rocky.
Hiya, Gus. We want to head without you, if you don't mind.
I want to talk a little. Would you like to step outside?
Not particularly.
All right.
If you're trying to bribe me, that'll do it.
You spent $265 on clothes today, Rocky.
Is that illegal?
With these bills, it is. Where'd you get them?
I bet some money on a horse.
They're part of the Aetna payroll. Got any more? Where's the rest? There's lots more.
I told you I made a bet on a horse. If you checked me at the dress shop, you should have placed me at the cigar stand.
I'm a busy man. I didn't wait for you to come out of Mrs. Fletcher's apartment. What did you go up there for? I could have told your husband was dead. How is Mrs. Fletcher?
I think I'll leave.
Nancy, you might as well give him yours, too.
You kidding?
Somebody's loaded us up with hot money. It isn't worth a nickel.
All right, Fingers, hand it over.
Are you kidding?
The man wants it now.
So you bet on a horse, huh? Where'd you get the money to bet with?
Castro loaned me $500.
Okay, Rocky, who booked the bet for you?
The girl at the cigar stand in the Crosley Hotel.
Fine, and who paid you off?
Guy named Harry, delicatessen, same building.
All right, let's go check. We'll start with Harry and work back.
I'm sorry, Nancy. You want to stay here, or would you like to go home?
I don't want to stay here.
You kids go on home. I'll be there in about an hour.
Don't be too sure.
I said an hour.
Hey, where's Harry?
Harry?
Yeah, the guy you dug out of the back room this afternoon.
You must be mistaken, mister. There's no Harry here. And there ain't any back room.
Oh, give me that. Hey, this isn't funny. Where is he? The guy who paid me off.
Paid you off?
The guy with the wife and kids who talked and talked. Where is he?
Take it easy. Come on. Strike one. Crosley Hotel? Come on.
Look, honey, Hey, where's the girl who was here earlier today?
I don't know what you're talking about. I've been here all day.
I was in here and made a $500 bet on a horse.
We don't book any bets.
There was a very pretty girl here. Where is she?
Are you sure this is the right place?
No, this is a gag. She said she lived in 201.
All right, let's go see.
I expected to find the girl from the cigar stand up here.
Oh, you did you? Well, I came back from out of town unexpectedly today, so there won't be any party tonight. Now, beat it!
Strike two. You know, Rocky, I think we better get out of my office.
All right.
Anything for me, Frank?
Not a thing, Lieutenant.
Get me Louis Castro on the phone.
Right, sir.
Sit down. This may take a little time. Maybe 20 years.
What a prize sucker I am. Were you in on the frame, too?
All you smart guys are prize suckers, and I don't have to be too bright to trip you up. All I have to do is watch and wait. Sometimes not so long, either. Yeah?
I have Castro for you, Lieutenant. He's in his office.
Okay, thanks. Castro? Lieutenant Cobb, a couple of questions. I've got Rocky Malloy down here. He says you told him to bet on a horse last night.
Rocky Malloy? Is he in town? Now, would I be donating to Rocky Malloy? He's lying. Hasn't been around.
Okay, just checking.
Strike three.
Ball one. Castro is high and wide since you were never around there.
Well, you can't believe that. You saw me come down from his office.
I'm surprised at him slipping like that.
That phony bookie was just a plant to get that hot money on me.
I wouldn't know.
You gonna hold me?
No, I don't think I will. I've been waiting for 5 years for some of that money to show up. Whether you got it or just scaring it into circulation, I don't know yet. As a matter of fact, I don't care. So go on, keep poking around. We'll see what happens.
Old clay pigeon me.
Yeah, you're expendable, Rocky.
Hey, you've got all my dough. How about some cab fare?
What are you going to pay me back with, some more of that hot money?
Maybe all of it.
All right, there's 20. That's out of my own pocket. Remember, I got a wife and a couple of kids.
I haven't met anybody lately who hasn't.
Or do you want some more water? All right, don't talk, but you're gonna listen real hard. You don't want to stop, do you, stupid? I'm out one day and you try to fix it so I'm right back in again.
How big does the 50 grand look now?
Can I get up?
You can't move one inch. I love to see a big, legitimate man like you flat on your back. In case you're curious why Cobb didn't hold me, you slipped up, Castro. He followed me to your place last night, which makes that little lie of yours about not seeing me kind of curious. He's beginning to wonder about a few things. That money's beginning to tie right back to you.
Why don't you calm down?
Because I don't feel calm. I talked to a woman today who told me about a Mr. Fletcher who was bribed to identify me. You know anything about that?
All right, you want the money. Let's make a deal.
You got another horse for me?
Let me get up.
I'll put this right through your skull if you get up before I tell you.
I'll get the money for you.
I don't want the 50 now. I want all of it.
How can I get it all? I've only got half of it.
You can use that fertile brain of yours to figure that out. You make one more cute move and see how long you live.
I'll have it all by tomorrow morning.
You sure will. Now get up.
$20? Gee, I can't crack that.
Now, come on, we'll get it.
He's back. Well, that was a long hour.
Got any good money?
Yeah, a little. Why?
Pay the cab driver.
How much?
$1.95.
Here's $2. Keep the change and don't lose your head.
Wasn't a very successful celebration.
What doesn't matter? You can take those presents back tomorrow.
Nancy, I didn't expect to do what I'm doing without getting in a little trouble.
Well, what are you trying to do? Get back to where Danny is?
Looks like we're about to have a very tense moment. Look, it's 1:45. We got plenty of time to make it to a bar for a nightcap.
Time doesn't matter. I know a bartender.
Keep this for me, will you, pal? You carry the money this time. We'll see if I can steal it from you.
Aren't you the comic and insulter?
Where are the car keys? If I'm not back by Tuesday, drag the river.
Good night.
Aren't you taking an awful lot on yourself? Danny asks you not to. I ask you.
I'm getting close, Nancy.
But one thing you seem to have forgotten, Danny doesn't get out in 6 months. He merely comes up for parole. Everything you're doing is just going to make it that much harder for him.
Believe me, it isn't. I wouldn't take a chance with that.
Don't you think that should be up to him? After all, you're already out.
I'm too close. I'm not going to quit now.
Oh, sure, Rocky. Have it your way. You always have. Rocky's going to help his friends, even if it kills them.
You can't really think that.
Oh, I'm just sick of the whole thing. I've been living with this hanging over my head for 5 years.
I'm trying to fix it so it'll be easier for you from now on.
Well, you're not. You're just messing everything up. You've always been stubborn. You make up your mind and nobody can change it. Not even me.
For this one, she's dead.
Go on, I said. Call an ambulance.
He's still alive?
Yeah, who are you?
Police. I'm tailing you for a cop.
Well, you did a great job. Where's the guy who did this?
Guys, two of them. My car was headed in the wrong direction. They were out of sight by the time I got the door open. You better leave him alone till the doctor gets here.
Rocky, they thought that was you.
Of course they did.
And me.
They just didn't care who they got as long as they got me.
Rocky, they thought that was me.
Take it easy, dear.
Don't go anywhere, Malloy. Cobb will want to see you. I don't want to have to look all around for you.
No good mess. They were after me, got you. Sorry.
What's the difference, this or an alcoholic ward? How bad's Darlene?
As bad as she can get.
That's a shame. I was getting awful fond of that little pickpocket.
Yeah, I know.
Look, Rocky, this thing's getting rough. I think you got your neck out too far.
Don't worry about it.
Let's forget our whole deal and go fishing or something.
You like fishing?
Used to. At least it's healthy.
You sure you don't know who did the shooting?
No.
By the way, officer, I'd like to talk to Lieutenant Cobb.
Tell him. It's about that phony alibi you gave for Malloy here. Cobb knows all about it. He's even discussed it with the DA.
I figured. That's not what I want to talk to him about. Tell him that unless he wants me to sue the city, he better do something about getting me a new wooden leg.
I'll mention it to him.
Yeah. See if he can get it in knotty pine. I want it to match my den.
Come on, Malloy. Cobb's waiting for you.
All right.
Rocky.
Yeah?
I know where we can pick up a couple of fishing poles, cheap.
Plenty of time.
Look, they made a mistake. That doesn't mean they're gonna stop trying.
For rubbing.
Just like the old days, blazing guns and big black limousines. Aren't you indignant and don't you want to call for your attorney?
He's on his way.
Well, this is murder. Not just a cheesy matter of some hot money, but a dead girl and a shot-up soldier. You know they were after you, of course.
Doesn't take an IQ of 150 to figure that.
And you, Mrs. Morgan, except for a little mistake, you'd be lying on a slab in a morgue right now. Can you think of any reason why?
No. I can't imagine.
I'm not asking you to imagine anything. You're alive on a rain check. You'd better start remembering anything that might help me. Where were you last night when someone took a shot at Rocky?
I was in bed.
Sound asleep, huh? And it never even woke you.
Lay off her, Gus.
Oh, sure. I don't want to upset anybody. What's a little thing like murder? And you were in your bar having a drink with a couple of friends.
That's easy enough to check.
Yeah, you'd be awfully sure of that. Yet you were home earlier when Rocky slapped you around a little.
That's right.
Why did you go back to your bar?
I couldn't sleep.
I can't hold any of you, but I want you to know my fondest hope is that one of you bumps the other off so I can pick up who's left.
Are we through?
You are when I say so. Now just get it through your heads that the pressure's on. I wouldn't give a nickel for your husband's chances before that parole board with all this going on. And I wouldn't give a nickel for your chances with those two apes running around looking for you. For you, I just wouldn't give a nickel. You two can go now. Not you. Oh, Rocky. I'm taking the tail off you. You're on your own now.
You picked a swell time to do it.
That's what I figured. We'll wait for your attorney. I love to watch them operate.
Wait for me, driver. I'll be right back.
Don't go.
I won't be gone long.
Rocky, please don't go. I couldn't stand it if anything happened to you.
Nothing's going to happen to me.
If I told you, you meant everything in the world to me.
Don't talk like that, Nancy.
I can't help it. I don't care anymore. Maybe I shouldn't say it, but I'm going to anyway.
No, you're not. You're going to stay here and get some sleep, and I'll be back in a little while.
Rocky, please.
I'll be back.
Chump, Rocky. This is exactly what Cobb wanted you to do.
Your place.
It's too early. It's not even open. There's nobody there.
That's why we're going to your place. Get in. Stop right there. Get up there and lie down.
Lie down?
We seem to talk better when you're flat on your back.
You know, there's no use kidding you, Rocky. I've been out to get you. I was kind of a chump to fool around with this at all. Like I told you before, I'm 60% legitimate now. You know, Cobb doesn't have anything on us yet. He's trying to get us to fight it out for him.
What are you doing?
You ever hear of a game called Russian roulette? It's supposed to show how much nerve you have. Six chambers, one bullet.
Oh, no, wait a minute, Rocky. Take it easy, Rocky.
Every time I spend this, you've got a 5-to-1 chance. That's better odds than you gave my friends last night.
Look, Rocky, the money's in the safe underneath this desk.
I'm not interested in the money now.
Look, Rocky, I'll tell you where the rest of it is. It'll be a cinch for you to pick it up.
That was a messy killing, Castro. A pretty little girl isn't so pretty anymore. A one-legged Marine is all shot up just because somebody thought he was me.
You'll have $100,000, Rocky. I'll help you get out of the country, huh?
You don't get the idea, do you?
Well, you cut that out of me. Look, you drag me into this thing and you're gonna ruin a couple of your very best friends.
Like who?
If you hadn't been so thick-headed, you'd have seen it a long time ago. Danny pulled that stick up with me. You turned it down, but he didn't. No, it's the truth, Rocky. Danny killed the guard. Richard identified him before I got to him with the $5,000. He agreed to frame you and name Danny as an accessory. Who do you think has the other half of the dough?
Who?
Nancy, his wife. How do you think I knew you were coming to my office the other night? She called and told me you were on your way over packing a gun.
Go on.
She's been trying to keep your nose out of everything. She even took a shot at you to scare you off.
So you tried to kill her along with me?
Well, she was shooting off her mouth about Fletcher. You said so yourself.
All right, stupid. Pick up the phone and call cop.
You're nuts, Rocky.
You want to play some more?
What am I supposed to tell him?
Tell him to get over here. You're going to make a confession.
Take it easy with that thing. Look, Rocky.
You're stretching your luck.
Yeah?
Lieutenant Cobb, please. This is Louis Castro.
What's the matter, Castro?
Hello, Cobb. This is Louis Castro. Get over to my place. I'd like to make a full confession.
You in trouble?
Yeah. Rocky Malloy is with me here now.
He'll be right over.
Thanks, Lieutenant. Well, that's that. Now, will you put that thing away?
I don't think we're going to play with this anymore. Now that you've called your two boys, let's really call Gus Cobb. I think he'd like to meet them. And do me a favor, Castro, while I'm on the phone. Try to jump me. I'd love nothing better than shooting you right in the belly. You shouldn't be too anxious to get on there. The boys might think you called him into a trap.
Give me a break, Rocky. Let me get out the back door.
Your first 6 months in jail, Castro, are going to be a little rough. You won't be able to sleep much. You'll be wondering what your friends are doing.
I'm not going to take this alone. I'll spill everything I know about Danny and the girl.
Of course, it won't be as tough on you as it was on me, because you really belong there.
This wasn't my idea. I only worked for Castro.
I know all that. Give me the key to this joint.
I haven't got a key. I'll tell you anything you want to know. Give me a break,
will you?
Take
him away. You wait for the coroner. One in the back way.
You hear that, Castro? That's the heavy foot of the law. Get yourself a good lawyer. If you're lucky, you might get off with life, like I did. The money's in a safe under the desk.
Take care of him. Wait a minute, Rocky. I don't suppose you have a permit for this. How much of the money's under the desk?
His half.
Where's the rest?
I don't know. I said I didn't know.
Rocky. I'm so glad you're back. I've nearly been out of my mind. Where have you been?
Looking for Castro.
You found him?
I went to his apartment, to his office. He's hiding out somewhere. Or looking for me.
You've got to get away from here. Go somewhere where Castro can't find you.
I've been thinking about it.
Take me with you.
Take you?
Yes, Rocky, please.
Where would we go?
Any place. It doesn't matter. We've just got to get away.
Well, that isn't so easy.
But you can't go without me. I couldn't stand to be alone again.
Danny will be out in 6 months. You can stand 6 months.
Rocky.
What is it, Nancy?
I'm not going to wait 6 months for Danny. If he got out tomorrow, I wouldn't wait. And you know why.
No. You tell me why.
You're just afraid to admit it. But you know. Take me with you.
I haven't got the cab fare to get us to the city limits.
I've got some money.
You couldn't be making much of that job you're doing.
I've got enough to take us as far as we want to go. To the other end of the world. Away from Castro. Away from everything.
That's a long way.
Not if you've got $50,000.
No, not if you've got $50,000.
It's in a suitcase in William's basement.
In the old house?
Well, I couldn't tell you before. I'm surprised you didn't guess. Danny was in on it. I've had the money all the time.
5 years.
Oh, I wanted to do something, but I couldn't.
The whole trial, you didn't say anything.
Rocky, I couldn't. Castro told me if I said anything, I'd be arrested for having the money.
You had the money and I went away for 5 years.
Oh, I didn't want to see you go to prison, but I was afraid. Afraid of Castro.
Why didn't you tell me when I got out, Nancy?
I don't know. I don't know. Oh, but we can forget all that. It's all worked out now. You're free and we're back together again. That's all that matters. It's always been you and me, Rocky. You know that.
Yeah. It's always been you and me.
Darling, what's the matter? You've always been in love with me. You still are, aren't you?
I still am.
Then you'll get me out of here.
I'll get you out.
This morning. Can we leave right away?
We'll leave right away.
Oh, I'll get packed.
Sure.
You'd better get packed, too.
Sure.
Darling, we'll have such a wonderful life together. Hurry.
Rocky, I just came from the hospital. DeLong's gonna be all right.
Thanks.
Did you find the rest of the money?
Yeah, it's in a suitcase in the basement of the old house.
I knew it couldn't be in her trailer. I've had it searched a dozen times.
You might as well pick her up. She'll be packed.
You feel pretty rotten about it, don't you?
How would you feel?